going on, Timpus here, and welcome back to another video on my channel. So you're probably wondering where have I been, and basically I've been ill for like the whole of the week, so I've not been able to record or upload, but now I'm feeling a bit better, still a bit ill, but I'll be getting a video out today. It's going to be how to make an epic gaming logo, and it's like a pixelated effect. It looks really cool. I have done it on one of my apparel t-shirts, so yeah, it's really nice. So yeah, if we can smash 500 likes on this video, that would be amazing, guys. Let me know what video you want to see from me next, and let's get straight into the tutorial. Right, so we are here in Photoshop. Now you want to open up any document. I've just got a 500 by 500 document up. So the first thing we're going to do is get a letter up. So go to the text tool, and I'm just going to use the letter T. So as you can see, you need to make it black. We're going to start off with black. Now you want to increase the size. It's pretty big, and you can literally use any font you want. I'm just gonna go with something pretty simple. Let's just go through. I'm not really sure which one to use. You want something quite bold, I think. It would look better with something bold, in my opinion. I think I might just go with this, to be honest. It looks nice. You can edit it yourself. So if you press Control T, you can like warp it. You can hold down Control and Shift, and then move the corners and stuff like that. This will look alright, something like that. As you can see, you can make it wider as well if you want. So I'm liking that. So what we're gonna do is make a pixelated effect. Now you're probably thinking, by pixelate, you just go to filter, pixelate, mosaic, and then do that. But no, that's not what we're going to be doing. It's something else. It looks really nice. You just want to go to the rectangle tool or the single row marquee tool, any of these two right here, but I'm just going to go to this one, so like we've got more control over what we can do. So basically what you want to do is highlight a little bit. You can highlight the whole thing, but you just want to get a strip, and then use the arrow keys, and you can like move, oh, go to the arrow tool, and then you can move the part you've selected out a bit, and it creates this cool pixelated effect if you continue doing that. So I'm just going to do some more. Just go to the rectangle tool, highlight a little bit, go to the arrow tool, and then move it with the arrow keys again, and as you can see, it looks really nice. So just continue doing that. You can even move it up a bit. And what I also like to do is, you don't have to do this, but this will look pretty nice if you just highlight a bit as you've been doing, and then go to the arrow, move it across. And then what you can do is go to filter, distort, and then add some effects to it. So you could go to something like ripple, and add a ripple to it. It's totally up to you guys, but that's just a little, that's just an option you can do if you want to go further and make it look even better. But here's, we'll just carry on doing this and see how it looks. Maybe do one over here that goes all the way across, something like this. I might speed this part up a bit and show you the end result. So this is just a little example. It's not amazing, but as you can see, it looks really cool. Now another thing you can do is, if you duplicate it and then the one underneath, go to color, overlay, make it red, and then use the arrow keys to move it a bit to the right, and then duplicate it again, double click on the layer, color overlay, and make that blue, a light blue, and then move it to the left using the arrow keys. You get this really cool 3D just effect. It looks really cool, glitchy, and really nice. And it does look good on YouTube banners as well. So if you like, you want to do this to some text as well, it works exactly the same. It looks cool. So yeah, this is a really nice effect. I might actually give away this logo right here to one of you guys if we smash 500 likes. So let's smash 500 likes, and I think I'll give away it on Twitter, so make sure you follow me over on there, and if we do hit it, then I'll probably tweet something out, so stay tuned on that. And yeah, 500 likes, and I will release it. So yeah, thanks so much for watching, guys. Keep up the sick support of my channel. Let me know what video you actually want to see from me next. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video.